Cool, then let's come to the next measurement technique. It's defined in dash 5 of our IEC 61967 standard. It's the so-called workbench Faraday cage. And this is how such a workbench Faraday cage looks like. It's about this size. It's nothing else as a metal box. You can place the metal box on your workbench. Inside of the metal box, you are placing your printed circuit board with the device under test, so with your IC that you would like to characterize. You're turning this device under test on so that it's switching and operating. You're closing this metal box to have a kind of Faraday cage to get rid of all the external noise that can contribute to the electromagnetic emission measurement. But the question is now, how can you measure the electromagnetic emission? Well, we have learned about the DEM cell. So the ICE is radiating electromagnetic emission, radiating into the environment. Yeah, could be one possible option. But here it's a little bit easier. We are measuring the voltage drop on our signal return plane. Okay, so step by step, let's come to that. In one of the first lectures, we've learned about galvanic coupling, and the current is always flowing in a loop, and one part of the loop is the ground plane or the ground return wire or cable or whatever we are using. And due to the switching activity, we are generating a voltage drop in this ground. So, and the voltage drop can also be measured. So we can connect a probe at the one end of our ground cable or ground plane and at the opposite edge or end of that thing. And then we can measure a voltage drop. And exactly this is done in this workbench Faraday cage. We are placing our printed circuit board, the standardized printed circuit board with our device on the desk. One layer, the bottom layer, is a ground layer. And we can hook two crocodile clamps on the one edge and on the other edge of the ground layer. And then we can measure the voltage drop or the voltage potential difference between these two points while the IC is switching. And this is the basic principle of this workbench Faraday cage. One of my colleagues from former Siemens Philips in Eindhoven has developed this measurement technique. But the problem is it's not super reliable because it really depends on where you are clamping the crocodile clamps on your printed circuit board. For sure, you have to turn the printed circuit board also by 90 degrees, more or less in the same way as the DEM cell. But the connection between the crocodile clamp and the printed circuit board might not be that good. And then it also depends on the cables, how the cables are laid out. So it's, as far as I know, not that many companies are using this workbench Faraday cage. Okay, yeah, here it is how it looks like. So this is our printed circuit board. And here are the ground connecting cables. And you most probably also need a kind of box where you are putting some input signals, some power supplies, and this all has to be filtered. And then inside, as I said, you also have some cables, for example, here for the power supply. And then the final result also depends on how these all cable wires and everything is laid out. So it's a little bit more complicated to make reproducible measurements. Yeah, very often you're using this standardized PCB, okay. As the one that is used for the DEM cell, mm-hmm. This 10 times 10 centimeters PCB with at least four layers, where on one layer is the device on the test, and on the other layer is the, very often. Also, actually, it should be that on one layer is the device on the test with a ground reference next to the device on the test on this layer, and then on the opposite layer are all the components that are used to drive. And here you can see the opposite layer, so the device on the test is sitting here on the, in this case on the bottom side that is looking towards the bottom of the workbench Faraday cage. Yeah. But one problem with the standardized printed circuit board is that it's standardized in a dimension of 10 times 10 centimeters. So imagine if you have a very complex device on a desk, you need quite a lot of external components, and it's very complicated to place all these external components on one layer of this 10 times 10 centimeter printed circuit board.